More professional sounding vocals in 3, 2. I really wish I'd started doing this sooner, honestly. It's really simple and it's so much faster than traditional automation. We found ourselves a rare occasion where I'm actually complimenting Pro Tools because lately I've been on a little bit of a hate for them. Some of you may have seen this feature already, but there's a thing called clip effects now in Pro Tools that has apparently been there for quite a while, but I only recently found it, which surprises me because I do consider myself to be something of a Pro Tools buff. Clip effects is so incredibly useful, and I knew there was something like it that you could use in the like, top tiered cinema levels of Pro Tools for mixing with television and stuff like that, but for music, I didn't know it was available until now, and it does have some very great use cases in music production as well. I'm trying to keep this video pretty quick today, so I just wanted to show you my favorite use case so far, and that is using it to sweeten vocals. When I say sweeten vocals, what I mean is actually going and EQing word by word or line by line in really tiny micro adjustments on your vocal channel. You can do this with vocal automation, of course, but I find this new clip effects method to be much quicker and intuitive. So I've loaded up a vocal here so I can actually show you how I would use clip effects to sweeten a vocal. First, let's have a listen to this vocal, and then I'll tell you what I think we should do.
You can buy a bag from Billiard Square.
Okay, so that is a very cool vocal sound, but what I'm noticing is that some of the words round off and lose a little bit of their top end as he gets quieter. So to fix that, I can show you how I use clip effect. It's as simple as splitting the clip, making sure you have the clip effects tab open, and then adjusting whatever effect you would like inside of the clip effects menu. Once you have made the changes, those settings will be locked to that clip. So if I click on another clip, the settings will be flat again, and I can make another change as needed. So my goal right now is to go through this vocal and brighten up any words that were losing top end. This can happen to changes in volume, changing how a voice resonates, and also mic technique.
You can buy a bag from Billy. You can buy a bag. Bag from Billiard Square. You can buy a bag from Billiard Square. You can buy a bag from Billiard Square.
Okay, so that is sounding very natural to me now, so let's just quickly bypass it and do an A-B comparison.
You can buy a bag from Billiard Square. You can buy a bag from Billiard Square.
All right, I hope you found that helpful, and I hope you have other ideas on how you could use this as well. In the world of film, this is just a must-have tool, but in music, I think it is also extremely useful. That is a really quick way to just touch up a vocal and get a more consistent sound across the whole track. In addition, you could try to EQ up and fix weak drum hits that are a little off target, or for example, you could adjust your attack and top end in a guitar DI if your guitar strings start to die. There's also a dynamics section built into clip effects, but for me, I personally see myself using the EQ portion more often. I hope you enjoyed this quick lesson, and if you want to help me grow this channel, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you want to learn more about mixing vocals, check out these videos.